subsidiary books. In the last class, when I was discussing, I discussed a topic that is your accounting equation, accounting cycle. Therein I said that, you know, when an accounting cycle starts, it's always with the transaction, that is any financial activity the company is undertaking. Then is the part of recording, which is done in journal, and then is the ledger wherein the classification of accounts is done. But you know, there are certain types of transactions, the frequency of which is, very fast. The company is having a fast frequency of those types of transaction. For example, purchases, cash transaction, then your sales transaction. Okay, there are certain transaction which takes place in a company very frequently. So sometimes it gets difficult on the part of the company and especially the larger companies to as and when required the information, if they want to take some decision regarding the purchases or sales, to first of all check all the journal entries where the prime entry or recording is done, and then moving out to the ledger to see what is the totality, because generally ledger is not done instantly when the recording of journal is done. It is done after certain period or duration of time. So it gets sometimes difficult on the part of the company to take decisions as regard of this, you know, important transactions are required. For that reason, the subsidiary books have been started. Subsidiary books, as you can see in the PPT, it is prepared in order to save time and energy for the transactions which are very frequently occurring in a company, and those frequent occurring transactions are recorded in separate books, which are known as subsidiary books or subjournals. Sometimes this book are also referred as prime book of entry. Okay, we have different types of subsidiary books. One, we have the first one, we have a cash journal book, wherein the cash journal book are divided, as you can see in the slide, we have four types of your cash book. That is single column cash book, double column cash book, triple column cash book, and petty cash book. Then we have goods journal, which is known as your purchases book, sales book, return inward book. Return inward means the sales return, and your return outward book, which means the purchases return. Then we have for our bills journal book, that is your bills receivable and bills payable. And the last one is the journal proper. So let's begin discussion on all these types of subsidiary books, starting with the cash journal. Cash book is a book, is a separate book of prime entry, wherein all the transactions of a company which has taken place on cash basis are recorded. Once again, I repeat, cash book is a subsidiary book in which all the transactions which have taken on cash basis are recorded. It can be either a single column cash book, as you can see in the PPT. In a single column cash book, we have a debit side and a credit side. Okay. And second one is a double column cash book, which is otherwise known as cash book with discount column. You can see the difference between the single column cash book and a double column or a cash book with discount column. In case of our single column cash book, we only have one column for the amount. One column for the amount, that is for cash. Okay. Whereas in case of our double column cash book, we have two accounts or two columns for our, one for the amount of cash, the other is the discount. I would like to clarify one thing. it is not that the business is always having all the transaction on cash basis. I mean saying that there are many transactions, and particularly nowadays practically things are not done paying money or hand to hand. Generally most of the transactions are done through bank. So when you are being asked to prepare a single column cash book, it is always assumed that whatever bank transactions also take place, that will be assumed to be taken place on cash basis. That means directly the cash have been paid or it has been received, it will be assumed, and then whatever transaction is related to your cash or bank, that will be recorded in that column. Okay, and double column cash book in case if ever the company is having something through your bank or through your cash, whatever, that will be recorded in the cash column, assuming that all the bank transactions have taken through your bank or everything has been done on cash basis. And whatever discount the company is receiving or the company is giving will be recorded in the discount column. As because you people are totally new, I would just say one thing. You can see that in the column it is written a debit side and credit side. Just giving you as a hint, in the credit side, all the payment of the companies are recorded. That means whatever expenditure the company is incurring. And in the debit side, all the income or whatever the company has received is recorded. Now, moving forward, we have third type, that is your three column cash book, or it is otherwise known as your triple column cash book. As you can see that it has three columns in the amount side, one in the debit and the other in the credit side. We have discount, cash and bank. Here it is that whatever transaction on cash takes place will be recorded in the cash column, and whatever transaction through the bank or through check takes place will be recorded in the bank column. The one of the important aspect in your triple column cash book is your contra entry. The most important or one of the important concepts in your triple column cash book is your contra entry. Contra entry means there are certain transactions in which both cash and your bank account are involved, but these two accounts are opposite to each other. That means if cash account is being debited, then bank is credited, or else when bank is being debited, cash is credited. So whenever a transaction wherein the cash and bank account both are involved and they are opposite to each other, one is in the debit side and the credit side other, then that type of transaction or entry is known as contra entries. Once again I repeat, koi bhi aisa entry ya transaction jahan par ki aapka cash aur bank account dono involve hota hai aur aapka cash aur bank dono ek dusre ke opposite mein hai, ek debit mein hai, dusra credit mein hai, to aisa type ऑफ एंट्री को हम कॉन्ट्रा एंट्री बोलते हैं. जनरली ये जो कॉन्ट्रा एंट्री होता है इसका सिंबल होता है कैपिटल सी. और अगर कोई ऐसा ट्रांजेक्शन है जहाँ पे कि आपका कॉन्ट्रा एंट्री हुआ है, तो आपका जो आप देख सकते हो जो फॉर्मेट दिया गया है वहाँ पे एक कॉलम है LF लिखा है दोनों डेबिट और क्रेडिट साइड में. तो वो LF में जो भी ट्रांजेक्शन आपका या एंट्री कॉन्ट्रा एंट्री है वहाँ पे LF में उसी के सामने आपको C लिखना होता है, कैपिटल C. और उस कैपिटल C से पता चल जाता है कि ये एक कॉन्ट्रा एंट्री है. आप लोग को टू मेक यू अंडरस्टैंड मोर इन अ बेटर वे, आई हैव इन दिस नेक्स्ट स्लाइड गिवन एन इलस्ट्रेशन, प्लीज चेक इट आउट. Hope it is visible to you guys. Here you can see an illustration for triple column cash book is given to you, wherein everything, every data is given to you that they have started business with cash deposited in the bank, purchased office equipment, everything. Now you can see how it has to be prepared. Debit side, credit side, as I showed you in the previous slide, that what is the format. The format you will have to draw. And now, started business with cash, that means cash to capital. So you can see, as I said, as a hint, that in debit side, whatever the company will be receiving will be recorded in the debit side, and whatever the company will be paying, or it will be an expenditure to the company, it will be recorded in the credit side. So you can see, for example, in March 1, in debit side, and even on the credit side, for March 1, where it is written C. In the debit side, you say March 1, it is written to cash. It's a contra entry. For that reason, the symbol of C is given. And in the bank column, rupees 4,000 is written. In the similar date, on March 1, in the credit side, by bank is written. In the ledger folio, contra entry as a symbol is given and 4,000 is written. Let me once explain you this entry. In March 1, it is given deposited in the bank, rupees 4,000. So as per general entry, it will be bank account debited to cash. Bank account debited to cash. So as it is a triple column cash book, so as it is bank account debited to cash, so in March 1, in the credit side, we are writing by bank. In the ledger folio, as it is a contra entry, C will be written. And in the cash column, 4,000 will be written. Remember, because in the credit side, you are recording by bank for the cash amount. Again, in the debit side, you will see, as because it is bank account to cash, so cash will be recorded in the debit side. Under the bank column, it will be written 4,000, and for both the sides, C is written, that is the contra entry. I hope you people are clear with what contra entry is. Once again, I repeat, cash book is to record all the transactions relating to anything which is done on cash basis only. Cash basis only. The cash may be the actual or direct money paid, or it may be either through banks, issue of check, or payment through issue of check, or any receipt of check. If it is a single column cash book wherein only cash column is given, we will have to assume that whatever bank transactions are taking place, it is also related to cash. So everything will be recorded in your cash column. In the second, we have your double column cash book, where we have cash and discount column. And then in the third, we have triple column cash book, where we have discount, cash and bank. Important is contra entry, wherein any transaction, the cash and bank both are involved and they are opposite to each other. One is in debit, the other is a credit. It is mandatory on the part that contra entry has to be symbolized in the triple column cash book. And the last one, we have petty cash book. Petty cash book means, you know, sometimes there are few items which are very negligible amount the expenditure is done. For example, when it is a case of postage, okay, or any guest has come and for entertainment and greeting the guest, sometimes the company, you know, give the guest tea or coffee or snacks, they offer them snacks, or sometimes, you know, small expenditures are done for the guest, some gifts are given. Okay, but those expenditure as compared to the expenditure of the company is very negligible. But those are required. Even the company sometimes need, you know, pen and pencils for their clerical work. But those are also considered to be very negligible amount. So those expenditures which are very negligible in amount are recorded in your petty cash book. A petty cash book can be either a simple petty cash book or it can be an analytical petty cash book. The format which I have shown in the slide, it is a case or a format of analytical petty cash book. Okay, wherein your everything is given to you, that postage and telegram is taken in one column, your staff welfare entertainment is taken in another column, cartage, printing and stationery, miscellaneous item, and then the total is done. important word used or important system in your petty cash book is the impressed system. Once again, I use the impressed system is the system as per which our petty cash book runs. So what is an impressed system? Let me give an example. You know, you people are students. There are students who actually stay in hostels. Okay. Or nowadays, you know, the youth needs pocket money. So parents, it's not that haphazardly whatever they need, they are giving them as the money. Okay, so it is that what the parents sometimes do, the intelligent parents, they actually decide that seeing the expenditure of the student that, okay, you are staying in hostel, so it is costing you 2000 rupees. You know, you need to have food, so it will take around 2000 rupees and you're going playing everything. So totally, I think 6000 every month is enough for you to stay at Bhubaneswar. If this is the concept and this is the amount that the parent have decided. So what the parent will be doing in the starting of every month, okay, for example, this is May going on. Okay, so if when the student came in the month of May to Bhubaneswar, the parent gave the student or the child rupees 6000 and they have decided and fixed that every month 6000 will be paid to you. If at the end of May the student has saved for example rupees 1000, okay, but parents have decided that only 6000 is enough for the student to take care of and to stay in Bhubaneswar, so what the parent will do, 6000 is decided, that is the amount, and the amount saved by the student is 1000. So in the next month, starting next month, that is June, parent will be giving the student only 5000. That means 1000 saved plus 5000, 6000 again when July will start. So at the end of June, parent will see what is the amount left with the person. If it is 2000 left, that means again 6000 is required. So what the parent will do, the difference amount they will be giving to the student, that is 4000 plus 2000, 6000. So impress system means wherein the already decided that what is the amount required for the petty cash, a fixed amount is decided, and whatever is the difference amount at the end of the period or at the end of a duration, only that balance is paid. Because that impress system means that the petty cash amount cannot exceed, nor it can be less than the amount fixed. I hope you guys are clear with what impress system is.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, then, so let me move to next. But before moving to different subsidiary books, I would like to discuss one more thing, as because you guys have little bit idea of your cash account and today we are reading cash book. So let's just discuss once that what is the difference between your cash account and a cash book. When I started this session, I said that generally the subsidiary books are prepared so that the time and energy which is wasted in recording every transaction in general and then classifying in ledger, and sometimes when you know stakeholders or the people, the upper level management, when they need to take certain decision, they are not in a position to take because it's taking time from the transferring the things from journal and then to the ledger, so it takes time. So separate books are prepared. So cash book is a separate book of prime entry, whereas your cash account is something which is the secondary step, wherein from the journal something is recorded, or from the cash book whatever total or balance will come, that will be recorded in your cash account. Secondly, cash account is a part of ledger, whereas cash book is the part of your primary book of entry. Okay. And the most important thing is that in case of your cash book, narration sometimes are required, but in case of your cash account, there is no narration required. I hope you people are clear with the difference between your cash book and cash account. Now let's moving to the next type of subsidiary books. We have purchases book. Purchases book means any transaction related to purchases of goods only. Once again, I repeat the term. Purchases book means it is a subsidiary book prepared for recording of the purchase of goods on credit. Purchases book prepare होता है ताकि company जो भी goods खरीदती है on credit या फिर उधारी में, हम सिर्फ उसी चीज़ को ही record करते हैं purchases book में. कोई भी goods अगर company cash में खरीदती है, वो चीज़ purchases book में record नहीं होता है, क्योंकि वो directly cash book में record होता है. Once again I repeat, अगर company गुड्स का मतलब है कंपनी का जो काम होता है, ओरिजिनल काम. अगर एक कोई कंपनी का काम है आपका यू नो फ्रूट जूस बनाना, तो उसके लिए रॉ मटेरियल फ्रूट्स है. तो अगर कंपनी फ्रूट्स ही खरीद रही है तब जाके ही हम उसको गुड्स बोलेंगे. बट वो कंपनी अगर कुछ और चीज़ खरीद रही है तो इट इज़ नॉट अ पार्ट ऑफ गुड्स. हम परचेजेस या सेल्स टर्म सिर्फ कंपनी का ओरिजिनल ऑपरेटिंग गुड्स के लिए ही यूज़ करते हैं. ये बात को प्लीज़ याद रखिएगा. परचेजेस या सेल्स टर्म जब हम यूज़ करते हैं, वो सिर्फ और सिर्फ कंपनी का जो ऑपरेटिंग काम है, हम सिर्फ उसी के लिए यूज़ करते हैं. और आपका परचेजेस बुक प्रिपेयर होता है सिर्फ रिकॉर्ड करने के लिए वो गुड्स जो कि कंपनी उधारी में खरीदती है, कैश में नहीं. इस चीज़ को एक्सप्लेन करने के लिए मैं एक एग्जांपल भी दी हूँ. बट बिफोर एक्सप्लेनिंग अबाउट द कैश परचेजेस बुक, एक चीज़ इम्पॉर्टेंट है. आप लोग सुने होंगे अबाउट डिस्काउंट, आप शायद ये टर्म भी सुने होंगे, ट्रेड डिस्काउंट और कैश डिस्काउंट. मैं आपको बस एक आइडिया देना चाहती हूँ कि ट्रेड डिस्काउंट और कैश डिस्काउंट क्या होता है. हम जब भी एक परचेजेस बुक बनाते हैं तो उसका मतलब है कि कंपनी जो भी डायरेक्ट सप्लायर से खरीद रहा है उधारी में, उस चीज़ को रिकॉर्ड करता है. और जब हम परचेजेस बुक बनाते हैं उसमें आपका ट्रेड डिस्काउंट को शो करते हैं. हम उसमें ट्रेड डिस्काउंट को शो करते हैं कि एक कंपनी को सप्लायर से कितना ट्रेड डिस्काउंट मिला, ठीक है. और कैश डिस्काउंट का मतलब होता है कि वो डिस्काउंट जो कि कस्टमर को दिया जाता है. अगर मेरा एक कंपनी है ए, और मैं सप्लायर से जो गुड्स खरीदी और मुझे अगर 100 रुपया का डिस्काउंट मिला, तो ये मेरे लिए ट्रेड डिस्काउंट है. बट अगर मैं अपने कस्टमर को डिस्काउंट दे रही हूँ अपना गुड्स बेचने के लिए, तब वो मेरे लिए एक कैश डिस्काउंट है, ठीक है. तो आपका परचेसेस बुक में या सेल्स बुक में ट्रेड डिस्काउंट को क्लियरली शो किया जाता है, जो कि आपको ये एग्जांपल में दिख सकता है. आपको दिख रहा होगा यहाँ पे दिया हुआ है आपको 4 डेट, जिसमें कि इट्स गिवन दैट इट इज़ अ कंपनी एक परचेसेस बुक बनाना है यूनिवर्सल बुक स्टोर के लिए, ठीक है. यूनिवर्सल बुक स्टोर है जो कि फॉलोइंग ट्रांजेक्शन किया है. वो बुक्स खरीदा है July 7 को फ्र�म कल्याणी पब्लिशर, 5 एडवांस अकाउंट का बुक और 5 कंपनी लॉ का बुक, जहाँ पे उसको ट्रेड डिस्काउंट दिया गया है 10%, ठीक है. आप देख सकते हो आपका सॉल्यूशन में कि परचेजेस बुक का आपका किस तरीके से लिखा हुआ है. July 7 डेट दिया हुआ है आपका. पर्टिकुलर्स में डायरेक्टली लिख दिया गया है कि कंपनी का नाम क्या है, कौन सप्लायर है, कौन सा बुक खरीदा गया है, और आपका 5 कॉपी एट ₹20, 100, आपका कंपनी लॉ का 5 कॉपीज एट ₹15, 75, और आपको ट्रेड डिस्काउंट वहाँ पे दिया गया है कि वो 10% है. तो लास्ट में आपको क्या करना है, ट्रेड डिस्काउंट माइनस करके डिटेल कॉलम में, उसके बाद आप मेन अमाउंट कॉलम में शो करोगे कि आपका अमाउंट क्या है, ठीक है. ओके, उसी तरीके से आप देख सकते हो आपका जुलाई 17 के लिए भी दिया गया है, जुलाई 2018 सबके लिए दिया गया है. आप जब सोल्यूशन देख रहे हो, आप लोग एक चीज़ मार्क कर रहे होगे कि आपका क्वेश्चन में जो है चार ट्रांजेक्शन है, चार डेट है, जुलाई 7, 15, 18, 20, बट सोल्यूशन में सिर्फ और सिर्फ तीन है, आपका सिर्फ तीन डेट के बारे में दिया है, जुलाई 7, 15 और 20। रीज़न क्या है? क्योंकि जुलाई 18 का क्लियरली लिखा हुआ है कि गुड्स वेयर परचेज फ्रॉम NM त्रिपाठी एंड कंपनी ऑन कैश, एंड मैं बिफोर आई हैव सेड कि परचेसेस बुक्स मीन्स ओनली रिकॉर्डिंग ऑफ द ट्रांजेक्शन फॉर गुड्स ऑन क्रेडिट, सिर्फ उसी चीज़ को रिकॉर्ड करना है जो कि उधारी में लिया गया है, कैश में नहीं। नाउ मूविंग फॉरवर्ड टू योर सेल्स बुक, आप देख सकते हो सेल्स बुक का भी फॉर्मेट आपका परचेसेस बुक की तरह ही रहता है, ठीक है। प्राइस सेम है, आपको डेट, सेल्स, नेम ऑफ कस्टमर और आपको डिटेल्स अमाउंट कॉलम लिखना है। और यहाँ पे भी एक मैं क्वेश्चन दी थी, और सेल्स बुक का भी यही है कि इट इज़ प्रिपेयर्ड एंड द रिकॉर्डिंग ऑफ गुड्स सोल्ड ऑन क्रेडिट इज़ ओनली रिकॉर्डेड। कोई भी कंपनी का ऑपरेटिंग गुड्स अगर बेचा जाता है ऑन क्रेडिट तो सिर्फ और सिर्फ उसी को ही रिकॉर्ड किया जाता है। आपका ऑलरेडी यहाँ पे एग्जांपल दिया गया है और किस तरीके से ट्रेड डिस्काउंट माइनस वगैरह हुआ है वो आपको सब शो किया गया है, ठीक है। हमारा जो हम गुड्स के बारे में पढ़े थे, एक सेकेंड, आई केम टू द सेकेंड स्लाइड। रीजन बींग, हम कैश जर्नल या कैश बुक जो पढ़े उसमें सिंगल, डबल, ट्रिपल, पेटी कैश कंप्लीट कर चुके हैं। गुड जर्नल जो पढ़े उसमें हमारे लिए चार चीज़ इंपॉर्टेंट है, परचेसेस बुक, सेल्स बुक, रिटर्न इनवर्ड दैट इज़ योर सेल्स रिटर्न, और रिटर्न आउटवर्ड यानी परचेसेस रिटर्न। तो हम परचेसेस और सेल्स बुक कर चुके हैं, अभी हम डिस्कस करेंगे अबाउट योर रिटर्न इनवर्ड एंड रिटर्न आउटवर्ड बुक। ओके, रिटर्न इनवर्ड का मतलब होता है सेल्स रिटर्न, और रिटर्न आउटवर्ड का मतलब होता है परचेजेस रिटर्न। बहुत ही सिंपल एग्जांपल है, या बहुत ही सिंपल चीज़ है समझने के लिए, कभी कंफ्यूजन मत होना कि रिटर्न इनवर्ड क्या है या रिटर्न आउटवर्ड क्या है। रिटर्न इनवर्ड का मतलब है कोई चीज़ जो हमको वापस मिला, कोई चीज़ जो हमको वापस मिला हम उसको बोलते हैं रिटर्न इनवर्ड, और कोई चीज़ जो हम वापस कर देते हैं उसको हम बोलते हैं रिटर्न आउटवर्ड, यानी परचेज करके जब हम रिटर्न कर देते हैं उसको बोलते हैं रिटर्न आउटवर्ड। मैं इसके लिए आपको एक सिंपल एग्जांपल देती हूँ। आजकल के डेट में हम लोग बहुत ऑनलाइन ट्रेडिंग करते हैं, मतलब ऑनलाइन सब बहुत सारा खरीदारी करते हैं, स्पेशली आप लोग जो यूथ है आप लोग को अच्छा लगता है कि हम अमेज़न या फ्लिपकार्ट से गुड्स वगैरह मंगाते हैं। आप पार करते हो कि उसमें एक रिटर्न पॉलिसीज भी रहता है कि इफ़ यू वांट कि आफ्टर सम टाइम अगर वो मैच नहीं कर रहा है आपको जैसा चाहिए तो आप उसको चाहे तो आप उसको रिटर्न कर सकते हैं, ठीक है। तो फॉर एग्जांपल कि आप लोग में से कोई अगर सोचो एक कुर्ती कोई मंगाया, ठीक है, कुर्ती, तो फॉर एग्जाम्पल कुर्ती फिट नहीं आया, साइज ठीक नहीं है, तो वॉट यू विल डू व्हेन यू ऑर्डर, जब आप अमेजन में उसको ऑर्डर करते हैं तो आप उसको परचेज कर रहे हैं, आपको वो मिल गया, आप देखें कि आपको वो फिट नहीं आ रहा है, इट्स नॉट मैचिंग टू योर रिक्वायरमेंट, तो अभी आप उसको क्या करोगे, आप उसको रिटर्न आउट करोगे, यानी अपना जो परचेजर था आप उसको आउट भेजोगे, बाहर भेजोगे, तो ये आपके लिए हुआ रिटर्न आउटवर्ड। बट वहीं पर अमेजन के लिए क्या हुआ, अमेजन आपको बेचा था तो वो उसके लिए सेल्स था, बट आप क्या किए, आपको वो कुर्ती फिट नहीं आया तो आप उसको रिटर्न किए, तो उसके लिए क्या हो गया, उसके लिए सेल्स वापस आ गया, तो जिसको हम बोलते हैं रिटर्न इनवर्ड, ठीक है। तो रिटर्न आउटवर्ड यानी परचेजेस रिटर्न, और आपका सेल्स रिटर्न का मतलब रिटर्न इनवर्ड, ठीक है। ये बात बहुत बार ऐसा होता है कि स्टूडेंट कंफ्यूज हो जाते हैं कि कैरेज इनवर्ड, कैरेज आउटवर्ड, रिटर्न इनवर्ड, रिटर्न आउटवर्ड एक चीज़ है, तो मैं आपको आइडिया दे दूँ कि ये सब एक चीज़ नहीं है, ठीक है। तो आप लोग उस चीज़ को प्लीज़ थोड़ा ध्यान दीजिएगा। आपका दो चीज़ इम्पॉर्टेंट है, आप अपना सिलेबस में भी देख चुके होंगे कि आपका डेबिट नोट और क्रेडिट नोट। सो डेबिट नोट जो होता है वो आपका परचेजेस रिटर्न के लिए है, और जो क्रेडिट नोट है वो आपका सेल्स रिटर्न के लिए है। इसका मतलब क्या है मैं आपको आइडिया दे देती हूँ। डेबिट नोट का मतलब होता है कि जैसे आप अमेजन से जब लेकर आए तो अमेजन में डेफिनेटली आपको बहुत सारा मतलब रूल रेगुलेशन फॉलो नहीं करना पड़ता, पर जैसे कि कोई अगर कंपनी से अगर हम कुछ गुड्स खरीदे हैं, ठीक है, और क्या हुआ कि हम एक सैम्पल देखे थे, सैम्पल ए कैटेगरी जब गुड्स भेजा कंपनी तो वो क्या क्या कैटेगरी सैम्पल बी कैटेगरी का भेज दिया है, तो जो कि हमको ठीक नहीं लग रहा है हमको वो रिटर्न करना है, तो हम उसको क्या करेंगे, हम ऐसे ही हैपजटली ओवरफोन रिटर्न नहीं कर सकते, हम लोग को क्या करना होगा, एक डेबिट नोट है उसमें लिखना पड़ेगा कि हम किसको वापस कर रहे हैं, ठीक है, क्या रीज़न है जिसकी वजह से हम वापस कर रहे हैं, ठीक है। तो डेबिट नोट एक टाइप का आपका डॉक्यूमेंट है जिसमें कि कंपनी जो है पूरा इन डिटेल लिख देती है कि उसका डिस्क्रिप्शन क्या है, जो वो वापस कर रहा है गुड्स और किस रीज़न के वजह से वापस कर रहा है। और ये डेबिट नोट एक टाइप का रिक्वेस्ट भी होता है कि जो आपका कंपनी जो वापस दे रहा है गुड्स वो उसको क्रेडिट नोट इशू करेगा। क्रेडिट नोट का मतलब होता है कि जब सेल्स कुछ वापस आता है तो उसमें क्या होता है, डेबिट नोट रहता है कि हाँ हम आपको गुड्स रिटर्न कर रहे हैं क्योंकि वो हमारा स्पेसिमेन के साथ मैच नहीं कर रहा है तो हम आपको वापस कर रहे हैं। क्रेडिट नोट देने का मतलब है ये एक्सेप्टेंस है ऑन द पार्ट ऑफ द कंपनी कि ठीक है आप गुड्स हमको रिटर्न किए और हम वो गुड्स को एक्सेप्ट करके आपका जो भी पैसा हुआ है हम आपको वो वापस कर देंगे, तो उसको बोलते हैं क्रेडिट नोट, ठीक है। आप लोग देख सकते हो यहाँ पे मैं आपको दोनों डेबिट नोट और क्रेडिट नोट का फॉर्मेट दे चुकी हूँ कि किस तरीके से आपका डेबिट नोट लिखा जाता है। अभी बहुत कुछ चेंज हुआ है क्योंकि जनरली और आपका हार्ड कॉपीज इतना नहीं होता, आपका बहुत कुछ बड़े बड़े कंपनी सॉफ्ट कॉपीज में ही कर लेते हैं, और बट आप लोग जब देखते होगे कि आप लोग अगर अमेजोन या फ्लिपकार्ट या कहीं से भी ऑनलाइन आप शॉपिंग करते हो तो आप मार्क करते होगे कि आपके पास जो बॉक्स आता है उसमें भी बहुत स्पेसिफिकेशन होता है कि कितना क्वांटिटी का आप मंगाए हो, क्या प्राइस का मंगाए हो, कौन सा कंपनी का मंगाए हो, वो सारा डिटेल्स रहता है। और जब अगर आपको रिटर्न पॉलिसी पता है, जब आप रिटर्न कर रहे हो आपको बहुत बार वो वाला जो फॉर्मेट है आपको उसको भी रिटर्न करना पड़ता है क्योंकि उस पर वो विथ सिग्नेचर जिसमें कि सब कुछ लिखा होता है, आप कभी अगर मार्क किए होगे तो आप मार्क करोगे कि उसका जो फॉर्मेट है वो बहुत हद तक ये डेबिट नोट और क्रेडिट नोट डेबिट नोट से स्पेसिफिकली मैच करता है, ठीक है। तो ये था अबाउट डेबिट नोट क्रेडिट नोट, यानी गुड्स जर्नल कंप्लीट हो गया है। नेक्स्ट है हमारा बिल्स जर्नल, जहाँ पे आपका दो चीज़ आता है, बिल रिसीवेबल एंड बिल्स पेबल। लास्ट क्लास में व्हेन आई वाज डिस्कसिंग आई टॉक्ड अबाउट बिल ऑफ एक्सचेंज, एक टर्म था मैं यूज़ की थी, तो बिल ऑफ एक्सचेंज जो रहता है उसी का ये पार्टी है। बिल ऑफ एक्सचेंज के दो पार्टी ही होते हैं, एक होता है बिल रिसीवेबल, दूसरा होता है बिल्स पेबल। जिसको पेमेंट करना रहता है उसको हम बिल्स पेबल बोलते हैं और जिसको रिसीव करना होता है उसको हम बिल्स रिसीवेबल बोलते हैं। जनरली बिल रिसीवेबल वो होता है जो कि बेचता है सामान और उसको पैसा मिलना है, और बिल्स पेबल वो होता है जो खरीदता है सामान और उसको पैसा देना होता है, ठीक है। तो आपका बिल रिसीवेबल और पेबल भी बहुत फ्रिक्वेंटली कंपनी में इट टेक्स प्लेस, फॉर दैट रीजन सब्सिडरी बुक ऑफ योर बिल रिसीवेबल एंड पेबल इज ऑल्सो मेंटेन्ड। एज यू कैन सी यहाँ पे आपका टोटल फॉर्मेट दिया हुआ है, और दिस वॉज ऑल। ये जितना भी स्लाइड्स आई शोड, इफ़ यू वॉन्ट आई कैन इवन सेंड टू यू गाइज थ्रू persons involved. तो अगर आपको ये चाहिए तो I can give. So if you have any doubts now, you can share with me.
मैडम एडिट होगा?
यस सर, आई हैव कंप्लीटेड द ब्लॉक।
ओके, सो आई मे रिक्वेस्ट मिस्टर पृथ्वीराज मिश्रा, हु इज एन एकेडमिक कंसल्टेंट विद ओएसओयू, टू शेयर फ्यू वर्ड्स, देन वी विल गो टू द क्वेश्चन आंसर सेशन।
थैंक यू पृथ्वीराज सर, थैंक यू अपेक्षा मैडम,
वेलकम सर।
speaker, as your name suggests, I did not have to wait much because my apeksha was not there actually. Waiting was not. Anyway, I think ma'am has covered it in the most lucid way. I would like to add few points only for the greater clarification of the learners. Impress system in your house, you must have overhead tank where at a particular point of time the PSD water comes and fill it. Once it is overflow, then the tank is full. Throughout the day, for 23 hours 59 minutes you use the water, then again at a particular time the tank is filled. You should understand impress system like that. Impress system is a font. It is a small font replaced to its original amount periodically. Clear? Then your special journals. Madam has explained it. Special journals. Journals we have understood. Special journals are of four types. What are they? First of all, the first category of special journal is termed as day book. Day book, why it is termed day book? Most of the transactions in a business relates to purchase and sell. So day book consists of four types of journals. That is, four types of books are called special journals. They are purchase book, purchase return book, sales book, and sales return book. Fine. Then second category of special journal called your bills books. Madam has explained bills receivable, bills payable. Next is your case. Fine. Madam has already explained what a case book is: single column, double column, triple column. Last one is journal proper. Journal proper is that any transaction or any entry you.
Professor, your voice is breaking. It is not audible at all.
Not audible. Is it audible now? Hello.
Properly not audible, sir.
Just a minute. Hello. Is it clear now?
Yes, sir.
Clear. Is
yes,
it clear?
Sir. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
I think
yes.
Professor disconnected. Madam, I request you.
Sir.
No, I'm very much here.
No, he is here.
Then I think Parichar sir told that PR Mishra disconnected, something like that. Hello, ma'am. Do
no,
you
sir,
hear
please
me?
Please continue. Yes, sir. We can hear you.
Okay.
Now it is.
Thank you very much. Now I have explained you four types of journals. The last one is journal proper. Any entry which you don't have the scope to enter either in day book, that is purchase book, purchase return book, sales return book, or case book, or bills book, that particular entry will be entered in the journal proper. These things, this classification has been done only because of one thing, that the journal we have had should not be voluminous, because in a business a lot many transactions are to be entered in the journal. For the sake of greater clarification, convenience, accuracy, and not to increase the volume of the journal size, we have made these classifications. Then madam, come to your debit note, credit note. I think there is no doubt about it. Another thing, your bill of exchange. Bill of exchange, madam has touched upon in the last class, that is negotiable instruments. That is Negotiable Instruments Act 1881. We have got three kinds of negotiable instruments. What are they? Promissory note, bill of exchange, and check. Promissory note is issued by, like, suppose I am directing you to, making a promise to make you payment, that I promise to pay you a certain sum of money on a certain date, it should be in writing. Bill of exchange is that, here, what happens in a promissory note? Who gives the promissory note? The person who owes you money. in a bill of exchange, a bill is drawn by the seller on the purchaser that you are directed to pay a sum of money to me or to the direction of my order on a particular date. And also, madam has clarified how the bill of exchange is discounted in the bank, etc., etc. I hope in a brief, madam has covered a lot. That is your three kinds of casebook, single, double, and multiple, triple column, then your special purpose journal. I hope the learners have been immensely benefited by the lecture of Professor Raksha Sahay Madam. And any question is there, both of us will try to answer your questions. Thank you, ma'am.
Apriksha Madam?
Yes, sir.
Hi. Now you can take all the questions. There are questions are there. Thank you so much, Apriksha, sir.
Okay.
Should I read out the questions or you can read
on I can read, sir.
Okay.
The first question is given by some Prasant. Okay. Your doubt is on debit and credit note. Okay. Once again, I repeat. Listen, when the goods are returned, that means when you have purchased something or the company has purchased, they need to return the goods because it is not as per the specimen they required. So at the time of sending back the goods, a note or a document has to be prepared. In that document, everything is mentioned that what quantity of goods are being returned, what is the reason of their return, in what price these were purchased. Okay, so debit note is a document from the purchaser to the supplier. Okay, and credit note is that when the supplier is receiving or it's getting back its sales, which the company has sold or which the supplier has sold, then they will have to issue a credit note, wherein credit note is a type of acceptance that whatever goods the customer has returned me, I'm accepting it, and this was the amount and the quantity and the quality which the customer has returned me. So once again, I repeat, debit note is a note or a document which is filled up by the purchaser so that he can return the goods. And credit note is an acceptance on the part of the seller that they have accepted all the goods which have been returned and the amount therein. I hope you are clear.
She has rightly told, debit note is a request to issue a credit note. Debit note is issued, that means I have issued the debit note. Now give me a credit note because otherwise, मेरा पैसा आपके पास फंस गया है. मैं तो खरीदा था. मैं तो आपको वापस कर दिया. वापसी के साथ debit note भी issue कर दिया. आप मुझे आप credit note दीजिए. So that credit note देने का मतलब आप accept कर लिए हो return को और पैसा मेरे account में balance रहेगा या तो मुझे आप वापस करोगे. ठीक है. Credit note is a reaction to the debit note. Fine.
Apriksha Madam,
yes.
Mr. Prasant Barik has some other question too.
Narration. I saw. What is narration? Narration is a brief explanation of the transaction. Okay. Narration means it's a brief explanation of the transaction. Generally, when we start recording, we record everything in journal or your subsidiary books. So, you know, when there is a layman, because when we record something in journal, it is totally very technically things are recorded. For example, when I'm saying goods sold, then I will be recording cash account debited to sales. So it is not that every person who is dealing with the company or with the statement or the journal which the company is recording will understand everything. Means every technical language they will understand. For that reason, it is mandatorily in the format of the journal that after recording of every journal entry, a narration is recorded in bracket. So narration is generally a brief idea on the transaction for which the journal entry has been passed. basically the narration starts with either BEING, being good sold, or it can also be sometimes written as for good sold. I hope you are clear. Narration is the brief description of the transaction या कोई भी activity जिसके लिए कि general entry pass होता है. Sir, should I move with second question?
What is petty cash? Suchismita suddenly.
Suchismita has asked, what is petty cash? Okay, Suchismita, listen. You know, company is dealing with many of the transaction. For example, a company generally is a company of, you know, worth of crore rupees. So there are small expenditure also which the company does. For example, that for many clerical works, company sometimes require pen, pencil. Okay, company requires, you know, when there is a plant production जहाँ चलता है वहाँ पे कभी कभार क्या होता है कि प्लांट बहुत बड़े बड़े होते हैं और उसका कॉस्ट बहुत बड़ा होता है. बट कभी कभार अगर हल्का सा मैल भी जमा हो जाता है तो वो प्लांट ठीक से चलता नहीं, तो उसके लिए हम कभी कभार क्या करते हैं, कॉटन यानी कि रुई रखते हैं उसको पोंछने के लिए. कभी कभार वो स्मूथली मशीन चलता रहे इसीलिए हम क्या करते हैं, हम ग्लिसरिन या फिर आपका कुछ ऑयलिंग ऑयल देते हैं. ठीक है, और ये सब का जो रेट होता है ना वो बहुत कम होता है एज़ कम्पेयर टू जो कंपनी एक्सपेंडिचर. जैसे कि कंपनी को कुछ चीज पहले के जमाने में क्या होता था, हर कुछ हम मेल नहीं, नेट वॉज नॉट वेरी अवेलेबल या इट वॉज नॉट अवेलेबल वी कैन से. तो उस समय क्या होता था, बहुत सारा जो इन्फॉर्मेशन होता था थ्रू पोस्टेज जाता था. ठीक है, हम पोस्ट करते थे तो उसमें आपको जो स्टैंप्स लगाते थे वो 50 पैसा का स्टैंप लगा. या जैसे कि कंपनी को जरूरत है कस्टमर को हमेशा अपने साथ रखने के लिए, तो कस्टमर को प्लीज करने के लिए आप बहुत बार मार्क किए कि आप कभी कभार कोई यू नो बड़ा बड़ा शॉप, जैसे कि आप खिमजी का बात करो जो ज्वेलरी शॉप है, या फिर आप कभी बात करो कि आप लालचंद वगैरह चले गए, या आप कभी कभार बात करो मतलब अच्छा बड़ा बड़ा, जब आप कभी कभी शोरूम जाते हो तो वो कस्टमर को हमेशा एक इम्पोर्टेंस देने के लिए बहुत बार ऐसा होता है कि चाय पी लीजिए, कभी आपको वो ऑफर करते हैं कि आप कुछ कोल्ड ड्रिंक्स पी लीजिए. तो ये छोटा छोटा खर्चा है जो कि कंपनी का एक्सपेंडिचर के लिए बहुत बड़ा खर्चा नहीं, बहुत छोटा छोटा खर्चा है, बट ये सब खर्चा इंपॉर्टेंट है. तो कंपनी बोलती है अगर ये हर एक छोटा छोटा खर्चा के लिए अगर सब्सिडियरी बुक बनता रहेगा तब वो नहीं चलेगा, वो बहुत वास्ट हो जाएगा. ठीक है, तो इसलिए कंपनी क्या करती है, जो कि इम्पॉर्टेंट चीज सब है जैसे कि आपका परचेजेस, सेल्स, परचेज रिटर्न, सेल्स रिटर्न, ये सब को छोड़ के बाकी जो भी एक्सपेंडिचर होता है उसको हम पेटी कैश में लिखते हैं. ठीक है, तो उसको बोलते हैं पेटी कैश बुक.
ओके मैम.
ओके, नेक्स्ट वी हैव समवन हैज आस्क्ड अबाउट डिफरेंस बिटवीन परचेसेस बुक एंड परचेसेस अकाउंट. Purchases book means it is a substitute of your journal book. Okay, it is a prime book of entry. और purchases book का मतलब होता है एक ऐसा book जहाँ पे आपका goods related to, आपका purchases related to goods लिखा जाए, and it is only on credit basis. कोई भी company अगर goods credit या उधारी में खरीदता है, purchases book में आप सिर्फ उसी को ही लिखोगे, और जैसे ही आपका एक ट्रांजेक्शन उधारी में होगा आप डायरेक्टली परचेजेस बुक में लिख दोगे. ठीक है, और जहाँ पर कि आपका परचेजेस अकाउंट का मतलब होता है एक ऐसा अकाउंट जहाँ पे आप कैश में खरीदो या फिर क्रेडिट में खरीदो, उसको आपको लिखना है. और सबसे इम्पॉर्टेंट चीज़ होता है कि परचेजेस अकाउंट एक अकाउंट है या पार्ट ऑफ लेजर है जहाँ पर जहाँ कि आपका परचेजेस बुक पार्ट है आपका जर्नल का. ठीक है,
कैश बेसिस परचेजेस. सो वी मेक द पेमेंट इन इंटरमीडियटली मंथली और हाफ ईयरली और सिक्स हाफ ईयरली हिप फोर्टनाइटली व्हाट एवर इट इज. Because of the volumes of transaction, purchase book is segregated for recording all credit transactions. At the end of the month, the total will be taken to the purchase account in certain organizations, so that the total purchases can be revealed from the purchase account, both cash and credit. But purchase account records only credit transactions. Fine. Clear or not clear?
Clear, sir.
Okay. Somebody has asked, what is a voucher? Madam, should I reply to it?
Sure, sir.
Voucher has, the word voucher has different connotation at different places. Gift voucher. You purchase something from a shop, you got a gift voucher. That piece of paper will entitle you either to a discount or to certain benefits. Voucher. But if you go to a bank, the meaning of voucher is something else. A voucher is prepared whenever either a particular transaction is to be affected by means of a voucher only. In bank, two types of vouchers are prepared, debit vouchers and credit vouchers, depending on the nature of transaction. Okay, so voucher is simply, you can say, it's a type of piece of paper which entitles you to some benefits. It may be a gift voucher, it may be a transaction voucher, it may be a discount voucher. Okay, it may be a voucher for free ticket in the mall or in your cinema hall, whatever it is. That is a voucher. Okay. I think no more questions are there, ma'am.
No, sir. There are two questions left, I suppose. Someone has asked, is petty cash closed in the last date of every month? No, it is not as such. It depends on the company that petty cash, you know, it can be that every fortnightly it is given, or it can be on weekly basis. It is totally on the company to decide that what will be the duration for your petty cash. It is not that every month. I think Asit has asked this question. Is petty cash closed in the last date of every month? It is not as such, Asit. It is totally on the company to decide on the duration.
Right. Rightly said, madam. There is no fixed guidelines for closure of the petty cash book. Even in certain cases, the petty cash books are closed weekly basis also. If the transactions are huge, small payments are huge, they can decide to close it on the daily basis also. There is no harm, because what is the meaning of devising a petty case book? Petty means what? Petty means small. We call it na petty matter, petty issues, just like that. Petty means small. Small payments. Small payments are made through petty case book. So instead of passing hundreds of vouchers every day, suppose for a pen, one voucher, one bill, you will ask for two batteries for your clock. Then we will purchase two battery or three cups of tea, next two cups of coffee, one packet of biscuits, like that throughout the day. If hundreds of entries will be passed in the journal, okay, or case book, then you just imagine how cumbersome and how confusing situation it will create. That is why these small payments are recorded in the petty case book, and depending on the nature, volume of the company or business organization, it is balanced. Balance means what? The total, it is total housed for taken to the cash book, and the balance is replaced by again the cash book. That's all. Okay. Yes, ma'am.
Someone has asked about what is general ledger. Sorry, but I haven't heard the term general ledger. I know about general journal is there. Which is also known as your general proper, but I don't know if there is a term general ledger.
Yes, I will answer to that question.
Sure, sir.
I think he must be working in a bank, probably, or insurance department, or in a financial organization. General ledger is a term. I think the learner who has asked the question general ledger, he must be acquainted with the system of preparing day book, subsidiary books. In the banking terminology, subsidiary books are called subsidiary general ledger, SGL. Okay. When the total transactions, what are the transactions actually? Let us come back to the basis of accounting. All your transactions, whatever they are, they are going to affect either reduction of the asset or increase in the assets or reduction in the liabilities or increase in the liabilities. When the general heads, all the general heads through the subsidiary general ledger are total and transferred to the main ledger, single ledger, that single ledger is known as main ledger or general ledger. Okay. Any other question?
Ma'am, you can take next question.
Which one, sir? What is the maximum amount of petty cash? Maximum limit of
general ledger? It is over, I think.
Yes, sir. Sir,
any
doubt? Yes. No. Okay. Ma'am, please.
Another question is the maximum amount to be taken as a benchmark limit for the petty cash book. Probably that is the question. Okay. There is nothing. It differs from company to company, concern to concern. For your information, in our Odisha State Open University, we have got a different limit. But the same limit may not be applicable to Bhushan Steel, or the same limit may not be applicable to Rourkela Steel Plant. So the petty cash book limit differs depending on the nature of transactions, differs from company to company, organizations to organizations. There is no fixed limit for that.
Ma'am, no question. I think no question are left. So before we conclude, I may request you to share your views about the class.
My view. In OSOU, this is my third online class. I was. The 3:30 slot is a little tough slot wherein most of the people actually take their lunch and then I think they take rest. So when I had my first online class, there were only one student, so I didn't take the class. So I'm very happy seeing that even at 3:30, that too, it's very, hot today. Even after taking lunch, people are attending the classes and happy to see that they're actually asking questions even. Because I didn't expect that, so many questions will be coming. I'm really very glad. I'm thankful to Mishra sir that he actually is, helping me out very nicely in clearing the doubts. And he's definitely a very experienced person. And special thanks to Shimoy sir for giving me the classes and conducting it smoothly and helping me out that how, PPT can be shared in laptop. Thank you, everyone. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you very much, ma'am. Thank you for coming.
Dear learners,
thank you, ma'am.
Class, we come to the end of the session. So before concluding, let me thank our technical persons, Ms. Minati Biswal and Mr. Kirod Behra. They have done a wonderful job by giving technical support. And I would like to thank Mr. Prithviraj Mishra, who has joined as a learner. Just he has joined, but he is the academic person, academic consultant with the Odisha State Open University, a very experienced banker. So we are really honored to have you in the class, Mr. Prithviraj Mishra.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much, Apeksha ma'am. It was really enlightening class.
Thank you, sir. You
kept all those students captivated throughout the session. So thank you so much. And I request all those learners, they may disconnect themselves. And this is all for today. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir.
ଚାଲୁନୁ ଆଠ ଏମିତି ହେଉଛି ଜାଣିଛୁ କି ନା।